Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to talk about linear or a sequential or a serial search program in C language. Let's start with the linear search. Linear search, its introduction I have already covered in my previous video session. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner. In this slide, I would like to introduce the linear search in short. Linear search is the simplest method for searching. The linear search is very basic search where linearly or sequentially we will compare every element of the list with the key element. That's why called as the sequential or a linear search or a serial search. This method can be performed on both, that is on unsorted list as well as on sorted list. Usually the arrays are nothing but the set of values on which we can perform the searching operation. How this linear search works? A simple example I have taken over here. If I want to search a key 95 from the given set of values, so what I'll do, I'll start from the 0th position, I'll compare 95 with 100, it's not equal, it will move to the next position, my index value, will move to the next position, it will compare 95 with 12, are they equal? No, it is not equal, so again I'll move forward, I'll perform this task continuously till either the search is successful, that is the number found at any particular position in my given set of values, or I am at the end of the list. If I am at the end of the list, still my search is not successful, it indicates that the key not found or the search is unsuccessful. So to explain all these things, I would like to take the help of program how we can develop a C program for the same task. Before that, we'll see some test cases. If my list is unsorted list, then what are different test cases? First of all, if you want to search for a number or a key 46, whether this 46 is present in my list, yes, it is present. It is present at third position. So the position of key will be 3. Position of index I will be also 3. And my result is successful. The search is successful. If I want to search for number 110, whether this 110 is present in my key, in my list, no, it will start the comparison from 0th position and at the end of the list, the element is not present. So that's why position of key is not present and the position of I is nothing but the end of list, because at the end of the list, we are going to decide that the search is unsuccessful. So now let's move to the program where I would like to explain the execution of my code. So now here I have already written a code for the linear search for both the if my list is sorted list and if my list is unsorted list. Now let's start with the explanation. Before that, I would like to comment the code which is there for the sorted list, because currently we are going to see the program for unsorted list. Okay, so now here my array I have already declared, array with the unsorted list with the 7 values whatever I have taken for the case studies. So test cases, in the same way I have taken the array, I have declared one key variable with index I variable initialized to 0 and the position to return the position of found element. Here I am going to accept a key from a user. Now I would like to execute this particular for loop for all I, that is starting from 0 where I will be less than 7. For that all I will perform the task. Very first thing, I'll check whether at the 0th position or at the ith position, whatever the key I want to search is equal to the array element. Then key is found, my search is successful, and I'll I'll display the position of I where the key was present. I'll update the position variable to I and I'll break the loop. I'll check whether my position is minus 1. No, it will not execute this if condition and it will exit from the program. But if my key is not present at the ith position, what I need to do? I need to move forward to the next position by updating the position variable to minus 1. And in this way, my loop will get executed till the end of the list. If this condition is false, it will check if my position is equal to minus 1. I display key is not found. Now let's perform the operation or execute this particular code. The first test case was to search 46 in my given array. So 46 is present in your unsorted list at the position 0, 1, 2 and 3. So it should give the result like key found at position 3. Let's execute once again for the next test case. The next test case was to check to search number 110 in the given list. Whether 110 is present in my list? No, 110 is not present. So what will be the result? Sorry, key not found, to indicate that the search is unsuccessful. So in this way, I can perform the searching operation on the given unsorted list. Now I'll comment the code for unsorted list and I'll free or uncomment the code for the sorted list. Before that, we'll see what are different test cases we need to take care of. So now we'll move forward for the test cases for sorted list. This is the sorted list. 7 numbers are there. First key is 60. Let's check whether the 60 is present in my sorted list. Yes, it is present at the position 5. So it will return the key position 5 with the help of index I, that is 5. So my search is successful. Now let's consider the another number or another key which I want to search is 75. 75 is compared with 10. It is not equal to. Now here with the sorted list, I need to check one more condition whether the key value is greater than the value present at my array at index I position. If it is greater, then it indicates that somewhere else in the next position the key may be present. So this task I need to perform repeatedly till either my key value is greater or I am at the end of the least position. If either condition is true, it indicates that my key is not present. So now let's compare 75 with 10. It's not equal, but 75 is greater than 10. Condition is true. Move forward. Same condition, 20 is less than 75 or 75 is greater than 20. It will move forward. 30 is less than 75 somewhere else in the next position the key may present. So now 40 is again less than 75. Condition is true. Move forward. 50 is less than 75. Move forward. 60 is also less than 75, or other way around you can say that 75 is greater than 60. Condition is true. Move forward. And now I am at the position 6 where I am going to compare 75 with 70. Yes, 75 is greater than 70, but now I am end of the list. Means there is no more element present in my array with which I can do comparison. So I need to stop to indicate that my result is unsuccessful. As my result is unsuccessful or my number is key is not present in my array, so there is no any key position as well as I am at the end of the list. So position of I is nothing but the end of the list. And now the next number I want to search is 28. Now let's compare 28 with 10. 28 is greater than 10. So somewhere next position 28 may present. So now move to the next position. Compare 28 with 20. Again 28 is greater than 20. Somewhere in the next position the key 28 may be present. Move forward for 30. Now compare 28 with 30. Let's check whether 28 is greater than 30. No, 28 is not greater than 30. It means that this is the sorted array and there is no any more element will be present in my list which will be greater than 28, because 30 is itself greater than 28. So I need to stop at this position to indicate that my search is unsuccessful. Here the number is not present, so that's why there is no any position of key, and the position of I is nothing but 2, because 28 is less than 30. Search is stopped, break at this particular position. I'd like to explain the same thing with the help of my program. So now let's execute again this code. Now the remaining part, that is logic for sorted list, is now going to be executed. What was our test cases? My first test case was to check 30, whether it is present in my list or not. Yes, the 60 is present at position 5. We have already seen. Now let's re-execute the code to check whether the next test case, whether it is giving the correct result or not. The next test case to check whether 75 is present or not. No, 75 is not present. So what happened? Initially we checked 60 somewhere. Whenever the key is equal to array of I, it will display the key is found at position I. But if it is not, I need to execute this particular loop continuously till either they are equal or key is less than the array of S of I, that is ith element of my array is greater than my key. If both the conditions are true, it will get executed repeatedly. If the first condition is true, it will display the key found and it will break the loop. But if my key is greater than array element, then I need to go forward. But if my key is less than array element, I need to update my position variable and I need to break the loop. But what was happened with 75? Yes, 75 is greater than the ith element, that is end of the list, that was 70. But if I will perform I++, then what will happen? This condition will become false, and at that moment my position was -1 and my I is equal to 7, so it indicates that I am at the end of the list and the key is not found in my position. I need to check both the condition, either or. If my I is equal to 7, I'll stop at this position. So in this way it is giving the output. Now let's execute for the third test case. Third test case was to check number 28, whether it is present in my list or not. So it is giving the result, that is 28 is also not present in my list, because it will check for the 0th position, are they equal? No, I++. It will check for the 28 with 20, are they equal? No, I++. Why I++? Because 28 is greater than 10 as well as 28 is greater than 20. I++. It will check whether I is less than 7. Yes. Whether 28 is equal to 30. No. Whether 28 is greater than 30, which is the next element. No. So what it will do? It will update the position variable to -1 and it will break the loop. Now here in this if condition, I is not equal to 7. I is equal to 2, but the position variable is -1 to indicate that search is unsuccessful, and here it displays the message key is not found. So in this way you can perform the linear search on both sorted as well as unsorted list. So thank you dear friends. I think this video is helpful to understand the C program for linear search for both sorted as well as unsorted list. Please do not forget to give the comment if it is useful for you. If you like the content and the video, please like the video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks, and do not forget to share it with your friends. Again, keep your bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of my new videos. Here I am providing you the subscription link for my channel. Please do subscribe my channel and some more useful videos for you. Thank you.